changed from the very first game when these two teams played. Scotland on that occasion lined up 2-2-6, and that was in 1872. This afternoon it's the more familiar 4-3-3. In goal, Ron Simpson, aged 36, playing his very first game for Scotland. At number two, Tommy Gemmell. At number four, the skipper, John Gregg. At number five, Ron McKinnon. And at number three, the last man in the back row, Eddie McCready of Chelsea. The middle three, Billy Bremner of Leeds, Jimmy McCallioch of Sheffield Wednesday, and Jim Baxter of Sunderland. And the front three runners. Now the English team are being presented. And let's have a look at the way they're going to line up. Again, the familiar World Cup lineup, 4-3-3. In goal, Gordon Banks and Martin Peters at number 11. The front line, Alan Ball, number 7. Jimmy Greaves and Jeff Hurst. And there's a great portion of this vast crowd here, 100,000 of them, about 40,000 of them Scotsmen. They've come here by plane, by train, by road. Tremendous number of flags of Scotland here this afternoon. There's probably going to be as much noise for Scotland as there is for England. And now we're getting ready for the kickoff. Shirts kicking off and attacking the goal on your left. Up with me in the box this afternoon, Billy Wright. Billy, how are you going to think this game's going to go this afternoon?
I think England just about win, Hugh, because they're playing together except for one. But I never underestimate the Scots because they're further and wanting to win or should make this a great game.
Ronnie Simpson gets the ball for the very first time. This is Jim Baxter for Scotland. But Law coming over to him. Tries a long one. Charlton now. Jack Charlton. Alan Ball. Bobby Charlton. But it's Billy Bremner coming in hard. A lot of men here this afternoon who play their football really hard. Is Jack Charlton. Aimless ball. Now Alan Ball for England. This is Jimmy Greaves. Hurst in the middle calling for it. Good strong tackle. Tommy Gemmell. And Moore will have to give this back to his goalkeeper. McKinnon getting under that one well. Now, Gemmell for Scotland. There was Charlton coming back. Bobby Charlton coming back. Now Bobby Moore. Moore again trying to find a free England man, but Scotland marking tight already. This is Hurst. Bobby Charlton. Hurst. Good ball. Martin Peters in the middle, Greaves is looking for space. Good strong tackle by John Gregg. And that was offside against Greaves. Baxter for Scotland. Law. Cohen playing very close. Baxter again. Law. McCready is making an overlap down the left. And a good ball to Baxter. Baxter had thought that McCready was going on down there. But McCready had stopped and gone back into defence. Bobby Moore. Hurst. Good strong tackle by John Gregg, and it's a foul. There he is, Jeff Hurst, a man who practically won the World Cup here for England just 9 months ago. Ray Wilson gets the ball for the first time. Baxter for Scotland. And McAleon. Jimmy McAleon having his first game for Scotland. Gemmell. Good ball for Law. And Wallace going down the wing. Well cut out by Wilson. Greaves has found space for himself. And Hurst. Well cut out by Gregg. This is Law. Styles gets the boot. Baxter again. Law for this, but Moore is first with the head. Bobby Styles. Bobby Chubb. Bobby Styles again. Greaves. Alan Ball. After Johnson pulled out of the game. Alan Ball, Bobby Styles, Moore looking for Hurst. And McKinnon slips, which gives Moore, which gives Hurst an extra couple of yards. There's only Greaves in the middle for England. It's an easy one for Baxter. Billy Bremner. Scotland moving forward now with Law. Charlton coming away. Now Alan Ball for England. Alan Ball trying to get through 2 minutes. It's Billy Bremner. Now Wallace for Scotland. As Gemmell going outside him, this looks a good one. Jack Charlton there with a head. Now Baxter. Pressure on England. Bremner. Gordon Banks now playing his 36th international for England. Moore now for England. And this is a good ball for Greaves. Oh, well cut out by McKinnon. Handball against Greaves. Referee Schulenberg of West Germany was quick to spot that. Now, Big Jim Baxter of Sunderland setting Bremner through. Bremner still there with it. Now Law. McCready calling for it. McCready gets it. Charlton under this one. Ooh, McCallioga now. Lennox. Gemmell coming in. This looks dangerous. He's coming again. Virtually short of getting his head to Gemmell's cross ball. Baxter, no. Referee Schulenberg says take the free kick again because Baxter was not 10 yards from the ball. And that's a corner now. Jimmy Greaves, the corner kick expert in the England side. Number 8, there he is. He'll take this one left footed. Simpson down there playing his first international for Scotland, thankfully taking this goal kick. Well, Jimmy, Billy, the pressure has certainly been on the England goal most of this game so far.
Well, this is the fervour of the Scots. They're wanting to do well. They've upset the England rhythm because of their quick tackling, and England at the moment have not found the rhythm. They're playing in a casual style where Scotland have raised the game much quicker than England have, and I think this is why the pressure has been on the England goal.
And a little desperate tackle just now which put Lennox down, who has given Scotland a free kick. And that's McCallion going to take it, sending it back for Gemmell. Scottish roars building up as Lennox, Bobby Lennox, number 11, takes this corner kick. And a chance here to go. Dennis Law looking a little downcast then. He really didn't get his accuracy in that one. Possible scoring position. Gets a little jeer from the crowd for that kick out. This is Tommy Gemmell with the throw-in. Skipper, Scottish skipper, John Gregg. Eddie McCready, number 3. Scotland again pressing forward. McCallion, but Bobby Charlton. Greaves, Alan Ball, looking for Hurst. Hurst giving McKinnon some trouble. And now this is Lennox. And a fine tackle from Big Jack Charlton. Brady to Baxter. Baxter and McCallion. Picking it up. Law is in here dangerously. Good jump by Ray Wilson. Prevented Law getting his head to the ball then. Bobby Moore. Not a very good pass from Bobby Charlton, I'm afraid. England certainly finding it difficult at the moment to find their rhythm, find the touch that they produced here 9 months ago. Touch which has given them 2 international wins since then, of course. Now George Cohen. This is Alan Ball. Now Hurst. And Wallace now. Wilson will get this one, and now the game has been stopped for a free kick, and at this time to the left of the field in the England half, Jack Charlton is down, and so is Lennox. Lennox, the Scottish winger, is down, and Big Jack Charlton is also down. These two went into a really, there's Jack Charlton, he went into a very strong tackle on Willie, on Bobby Lennox, there he is, number 11, 2 or 3 minutes ago, and both of them have been limping slightly since, and now with this free kick being taken, or being awarded rather, to Scotland, gives both chance for both men to receive attention. is a tragic sight for England. Jack Charlton, being supported by Harold Shepherdson, the England trainer, being helped off the field. Les Cocker, the assistant trainer, helping Jack Charlton off the field. A very tragic sight for England supporters. Now the free kick to be taken for Scotland by Gregg. To Tommy Gammel. Law is under that. Now McCready for Scotland, and referee Schulenberg has given a foul against Law for using his elbows in that jump in the air with George Cohen. As Dennis Law just lobbed the ball into a crowd of photographers and hit one on the head. And that's a free kick to England. It's a 10-man England team, with only 15 minutes of the game gone. In considerable difficulty now as Wilson lines up to take this free kick for England. Hurst there, Gemmell is there. But it's McKinnon getting it out. Only to Cohen. And Law fighting hard for this ball and winning it. McCalliog. Baxter. McCready making a burst down the left wing for Scotland. He gets the ball. Back to Law. Baxter and McCalliog. Scotland now moving forward. Well judged by Banks. Greaves. Baxter cuts it out. Alan Ball and Billy Bremner for Scotland. Bobby Charlton, a good ball to Jimmy Greaves. There's only Hurst up there with him. There's Hurst now. There's a chance for Hurst. First real shot of the game, and Ronnie Simpson handled it very, very well. Alan Ball, and again Hurst going up there. McKinnon first, here's Bobby Charlton. McCalliog. And suddenly the game switching with the pressure on Scotland. Baxter to Law. Bobby Styles finally clearing up the damage. Danger. Cohen now. Hurst. Greaves. And McCalliog. Baxter. McCready. McCready celebrating. Now Law. Bremner. Hard one for McCalliog. He did well to keep that one down. Good ball to Bremner. Now Baxter. Oh, what a chance here for Wallace. Styles. Bobby Charlton. Charlton moving forward here with great speed. Is he in with a chance? Oh, it was a fine run by Bobby Charlton. A really great one. Well, this is a body blow for England now, down to 10 men, Billy.
It is. I thought that something had happened there, Hugh, because the tackle was very strong indeed. But I think they'll concentrate on defence. And when one thinks that, Bobby Charlton makes that wonderful break. I think the teamwork of England here is going to pay dividends, because the pressure Scotland have been giving them has been very great. But nevertheless, the defence, as usual, has been very compact indeed.
that defence of England's is going to have to play very hard now. Oh, is it Law? Now Baxter, and the referee has stopped the game. He's seen an offence against Nobby Stiles. There he is. Nobby getting a bat on the head from his Manchester United teammate, Dennis Law. Billy Bremner, number 8. Making sure that everybody is lined up in the right place. Dennis Law, number 10, lurking behind. Is he going to take this free kick? Or is Bremner going to take it? Baxter is there, number 6. And instead, it's Gregg. Side of the field on the trainers bench below the royal box, the England trainers are working busily on Jack Charlton, trying to get that injured leg fit enough to go on with this game. Now it's Jimmy Greaves. Free kick for England. Hurst going in here. Ronnie Simpson, 36 years old, playing his fourth game here at Wembley. Brady to Law. Gemmell in the clear. His right back is seeing an awful lot of him, which is what one would expect. With England playing without wingers, one tends to see the opposition fullbacks come into the game. This is Gemmell, he's going to try a shot. But Bobby Moore, who got his head in the way of it. Here's Bobby Moore nodding that one away for a corner kick. McCalliog over there to take the corner for Scotland. Greaves, that's a bit short for Wilson. Now Bremner. England getting themselves into some difficulty. And then it's going with Bax. Now Cohen. Alan Ball. Flame-haired little Everton man. Bobby Charlton. Bobby Moore. Oh, Bobby, got himself in trouble there, and it's Wallace who robs him. Wallace still with it, Lennox going through the middle. Wallace, is he going to try one? I think if Wallace had gone another couple of yards, he could have given Banks a harder shot to save. McKinnon going with Hurst. Calliog wearing the number 9 but doing a tremendous amount of roving here. Good ball to McCready. Chelsea left back moving forward. Oh, deflection of Wallace's head. Gordon Banks playing his 36th game for England. And what a tremendous goalkeeper. What tremendous service he's given to England. McKinnon sweeping it up. Gemmell again. Mikhailiok going down the right wing. There he is. This is Mikhailiok. Gemmell. And Gemmell, it seems to be in some pain there. It's a good, strong, hard tackle by Wilson. The referee has not said it's a foul. It was a perfectly fair tackle. Gemmell rolled over in agony afterwards, off the pitch. The referee has given a corner. It's like Gemmell's right leg. German referee to say, come on, play on. The player is off the field. Alan Ball chasing, losing it. So Greg. Now Wallace. Jack Charlton is back on the field during the hold-up just now. Moving up into the forward line, in fact, favouring his leg. This is Bobby Charlton. Bobby Charlton again. Hurst now. And Wallace coming away. George Cohen. Martin Peters. Peters and Bremner with it. Bremner fighting on, and the referee's blown his whistle. It's a foul against Peters. Brady with a free kick to Baxter. This is number six, Jim Baxter. And a chance here, but Dennis Moore. There he is, a fair-haired Manchester United player. There he is. The dark-haired boy there, Willie Wallace, was the one who put the shot in. It bounced out and Dennis Law pumped it into the net. Well, how about that?
Well, it's been coming here, hasn't it? Scotland have been the more impressive side, and especially this Law. This Law has been the terrier of the first half. He's worked and worked and worked, and just reward coming to him there by catching that rebound and putting the ball in the back of the net. I think England are really up against it now.
Flags are waving and the roars of the Scottish crowd, because there must be 40,000 of them here, really making itself felt in the arena at Wembley. A corner to England. And down there on the far post you can see the big number five figure of Jack Charlton, back in the game again, but not in the defence. That leg is still bothering him. Alan Ball with the corner. And Greaves! A foul against. I think it was Hurst who was, Peters who went up in the air and used his elbows as that corner from Ball came across. So Baxter starts Scotland forward again. And Dennis Law has it. Mikhailiok. Dennis Law. Dennis Law. Bremner now for Scotland. Hurst. Baxter there, and these Scots are really turning on the pressure, really fighting for every ball now. Alan Ball. That was not a good pass. Bremner has it, and now Wallace moving in for Scotland. Watch him. Willie Wallace, there he is. The man who made the goal for Dennis Law, very nearly getting a second for Scotland. Peters, George Cohen, Hurst, handball against Baxter. These are the sort of positions where Bobby Moore takes free kicks and looks for his West Ham teammate, Jeff Hurst. Jack Charlton was there. There he is, Jack Charlton. What a tragic sight for England, limping up in the forward line when his strength and height are so badly needed in defence. This is Baxter. Gemmell making space for himself on the right. Scotland fullback. Was a bad ball, aimed for Willie Wallace, but not aimed very well. Now Greaves, Wilson, looking for Hurst, and too long for him, so Greg picks it up. Greg has McCready outside him on the left, and that's where the ball goes. Greg again, looking for Law. McKinnon wins that one. McKinnon and Hurst having a fine duel in the air with the balance about even at the moment. But now Gemmell, Baxter, McCready for Scotland. McCready trying to do a little too much that time. And handball again against Baxter. Trying to explain that he didn't handle it. Referee Schulenberg won't have any of it. Bobby Moore with the free kick for England. Ian McKinnon winning it. This is Lennox. Going over the top as Cohen came in on the tackle. Bobby Moore to Bobby Charlton. Easily cut off by the Scottish defence in the line. Bremner now to set Scotland going again. Law. Not a good ball. Alan Ball. Long lanky leg of Tommy Gennell stopped that one, but it's Hurst now. Alan Ball. Hurst. England just not being able to find their touch, unable to get the rhythm, unable to find their passing technique. Scotland looking much more hungry, much harder. Bobby Moore. Greaves. Not There'll be stars moving up on the right, but Greaves is going to work with, trying to work with Charlton, and what a bad ball that was, straight to Baxter. Now, Billy Bremner. Law. Good hard tackle by Moore. Greaves now. Hurst. Ball. That's an easy one for Greg. Slim Jim Baxter to Jim McCallion. Tommy Gemmell. Eddie McCready. All the Scottish side now moving forward. This is Wallace. George Cohen, and at the back there you can see Jack Charlton, who is just limping around the field, unable to really contribute anything to the England war effort at the moment. Charlton finding Alan Ball. This is Martin Peters. Nobby Stiles. Big roar from the Scottish supporters here at Wembley as he cut down the efforts of Nobby Stiles to get the ball across. But Nobby now. Charlton! Big Jack Charlton. Ray Wilson to Nobby Stiles. Finding Bobby Charlton. And Jack Charlton will just try and head this across the goal. Hurst. And it's the boot of Baxter. Now Dennis Law. That was a foul. Foul against Alan Ball for pushing on Eddie McCready. And now it looks like Jim Baxter down injured in the Scottish goalmouth. Number six, Jimmy Baxter. Sock pulled down on his right leg. Scottish trainer. Or the McCray there. Baxter looks happy enough. Doesn't look as though he's particularly injured at the moment. Just taking this opportunity to take a breather with Scotland winning 1-0. Finding Tommy Gemmell. Caleog. Gemmell going outside him on the right. Caleog across the middle. This is Alan Ball for England. Greaves. And a chance here. This is Peters and Greaves. He's offside. Dennis Law for Scotland. Jack Charlton trying to limp across there and do something. This is really tragic for England, Billy. They've had to pull, what is it, Nobby Stiles back to try and plug the gap left by Charlton.
This always is the case in internationals, Hugh, and it is, because this Wembley field seems larger and larger, even though you've got 11 men with only 10. With Jack being a passenger, it needs now real hard work that England are doing. I must say that they are really working like terriers, but this Scottish side are in full song, and it's even a more uphill battle because of this.
now Baxter. That's Charlton, Jack Charlton. A Hurst. Good, strong tackle from Ron McKinnon, number five, who has hardly left. Now Charlton, Bobby Charlton. Moore. This is Hurst to Wilson. And a chance for Peters that time. Jim Baxter. Scotland taking their time. Ball. Now Lennox for Scotland. Baxter again. Bremner and Law. It was Nobby Stiles and Gordon Banks combining together to stop that one, and Gordon Banks has hurt his knee. Law is also lying there injured. Nobby Stiles gets it forward. Long ball back to Ronnie Simpson, the Scottish goalkeeper. The referee still letting... And Ronnie Simpson very sportingly kicking that one straight into the crowd so that these injured players can receive some attention down in the England goal mile. There they are, Gordon Banks, Dennis Law. Banks hurt, looks as though he's hurt his left leg going down to prevent Dennis Law making it 2-0 for Scotland. And Dennis Law hurt at the same time. So, Bobby Charlton with a throw-in for England. Now, Alan. Bobby Charlton. Got Ray Wilson. Ray Wilson limping now as though he too has pulled a muscle or something. Eddie Bremner. To Scotland, to Bremner. Bremner aiming for McCready. This is Baxter. Gemmell going fast down the left wing, right wing for Scotland, but Scotland didn't spot him. McCready didn't spot him. Now Baxter for Scotland. Carry on. Wallace. McCready is under this one. Wallace. Cohen. And England constantly under pressure here, being hurried into their clearances, being hurried into mistakes. Bobby Charlton. And Scotland with a Scottish defence scuttling back quickly. Three, four, five of them back there now. Nobby Stiles. Trying to find Jack Charlton, but unable to do so. Well, I would say there's about a minute of this first half left on normal time, but there's bound to be some injury time added on. The injuries that we've had to Charlton, and Banks and Law, Baxter. This is Peters for England. Baxter may have difficulty now. Finds Greg. And McCready. McKellar. Lennox. Scotland moving forward. Watch out for Lennox's shot. Through there with a really good right-footed shot, which got a touch off an England player and curved away for a corner. McCready. Dennis Law. And there you can see number three, Ray Wilson, who has been limping quite badly this last 5 or 6 minutes. Jimmy Greaves, and a good strong tackle from Jim Baxter. Now it's Moore. Being hurried into a quick pass and not finding his man properly. The Scots boys fighting for every ball, not giving England the slightest opportunity to compose themselves to really get a grip on the game. Now, Hurst. Hurst still fighting through there, but the free kick has already been given against McCallaghan for an attempted little trip earlier. Referee Schulenberg on the spot to give a free kick to England, Bobby Charlton to take it. McCallaghan is much too close to the ball, he'll be waved back. Jack Charlton trying with his head. That is over the line for a goal kick. Baxter for Scotland, and we're in injury time in the first half. By Wallace. Bobby Styles heading clear. Wallace has it again though. Calliope trying to make space, but Peters is there. Ray Wilson. Charlton, Bobby Charlton that is. This is Peters. Greaves. Cohen. McCallaghan and McCready. Baxter. McCready. McCallaghan. McCready. Law going with Moore, but no. On my watch, we've had some 3 minutes of injury time now. It's Cohen. Alan Ball. Peters. Greaves now, and Hurst, but as usual it was McKinnon back there snuffing out the danger. Ron McKinnon, the big tall Rangers centre half, giving away a corner, Jimmy Greaves to take it. McKinnon again in the air. Charlton, Greg Charlton, and a goal kick. Jack Charlton, despite his injury, fighting for every high ball in the goal now. The referee Schulenberg of West Germany looking at his watch. He's in about the fourth minute of injury time, and he does indeed blow his whistle for half time. And that's the picture here at Wembley, England have got to do a lot in the second half to get back into this game, and we'll be showing you the second half in just a few moments, so join us there. So, England kick off the second half, their white shirts attacking the goal on your left, looking for the one goal that can really drag them back into this game, but thinking probably that their 19 games unbeaten streak is coming to an end. Remember, it was a Scottish side way back in 1896 that ended a 20 games unbeaten streak that England had then. They were hoping today to equal that record. But Law's first half goal has really set England a tremendous task now. A task that has been made no easier by the... This is Bremner. Scottish faces down there looking really happy. Gordon Banks was short of that one. Baxter now, McKellion. Lennox. Lennox for Scotland. Lennox breaking well into the clear. He's got Law in the middle. This is Law. Well done, Gordon Banks. Scotland fighting for every ball. Really bossing this game here at Wembley. Now Bobby Charlton for England. Styles, Bobby Moore. Build up slow. Now Alan Ball. Alan Ball past Gemmell. Bremner coming across. Alan Ball. Oh yes, must be! Pulled it down. Referee said play on. That ball looked over the line from up here, but the linesman was right on the corner flag looking across the goal and said no goal. Billy, what do you think about that?
I was very close, Hugh, but the linesman is in the right position to be. It's a great shame because Jackie would have scored that one. It would have been a real great thing for him, but nevertheless, that's football, Hugh.
Really brilliant run by Alan Ball to set up that situation for England. And almost, for a fraction of a second there, they were back in this game. Now, Lennox. McKellion. Trying to find Lennox again. Alan Ball. Nobby Styles could be in trouble here. Greaves to Peters. Back to Baxter. Dennis Law. Now Alan Ball for England. Bobby Charlton. Two men going for him. Bremner misses him and Charlton's on his own. The sort of position he scored against Mexico. Chances he really takes, and he hit Simpson. It looked to me as though he hit Simpson on the shoulder with that shot, but in fact the referee has pulled play right back, and in fact I gather that Mr. Greaves must have been offside at that moment. The referee is still a long way behind this game. Wilson, Ray Wilson. Ooh, that was a loose one. Bremner now. Bremner has three colleagues up with him. This is Lennox. And Moore coming away with it. Now Bobby Charlton. Aim for his brother Jack. Bobby Moore. Bobby Charlton. Alan Ball will get this one, but it's gone backwards, it's not going forwards. Alan Ball. Greaves. Bremner. And again, it's Lennox coming away for Scotland. Law calling for it. This is Dennis Law. England sprinting back to get into their goal mouth as Law puts Scotland on the attack again. Lennox. Law. A chance here for Gemmell. Big, tall, fair-haired right back of Celtic, Tommy Gemmell. Had a great scoring chance set up for him there by Dennis Law. Ah, this is George Cohen for England. Hurst. Well taken out by McCready, and it's Bremner now. Billy Bremner. Bremner with Peters, and Bremner wins it. This is Wallace. And that's a corner. The field, you can see Nobby Stiles down in the center of the picture there with his socks way down around his ankles. Billy Bremner too with his socks down around his ankles. It's Wembley turf dragging at the sinews. McCready for Scotland. Alan Ball. McCready fighting again. Alan Ball, can he keep it in? No, that's over the line. Alan Ball saying angrily there that he kept it in, but the linesman was there. Calliog for Scotland. Bremner. Now Greaves to Bobby Charlton. One for Greaves to chase. Dennis Law, the Scottish hero at the moment, the scorer of their goal. And Jimmy Greaves. Finding Hurst? No, he didn't find Hurst. It's McKinnon again down there. Now it's Gemmell. Cheers. Cheers, yes, but not cheers. McCready. Bremner. Baxter. This is Lennox. Took that a little too close to Wilson. Lennox still there. Good ball for Dennis Law. Law has McCallog inside him. Bad one, and Jack Charlton picks it up, but can't do much with it. The way Jack Charlton is limping, it seems he can't stay on this ground very much longer, I would think. Anyway, this is George Cohen for England now. That'll run over, I think. No, he kept it in well. But it's John Gregg. Jim Baxter for Scotland. Bremner. McCready. McCallog. McCallog here last year, of course, with Sheffield Wednesday, scoring a goal at Wembley. The cup final. This is Baxter now for Scotland, slowing the game down. McCalliog again, Baxter. England just don't seem to be able to take this ball away from Scotland. Brady, this is Bremner. As they tease and taunt England. England, the world champions, being taunted by Scotland. John Gregg now. Tommy Gemmell. Scotland moving forward again. Retaining possession of the ball. And they've still got it. Because this is Jim Baxter moving forward. Billy Bremner. Well, finally England get the ball back again through Bobby Charlton. Oh, and that's a loose one. This is Lennox. Now McCalliog. Wallace. Alan Ball for England. Greaves. Good strong hard tackle by McKinnon. Stops Greaves again. Bobby Lennox miskicks. Lennox is still there. Well, Lennox was trying the shot, and I think if he tried for the far post, Bremner and Law were moving across there. And the referee has given offside. Stiles for England. Peters. Cohen. Jack Sharp will be lucky to catch that one. He can hardly walk, let alone run. Gemmell. Now that ball's up. Throw into England. Greaves. Alan Ball. Ball still there. Charlton. It's a great shot. There he is, Bobby Charlton. Fair hair. The man who has hit so many great goals for England. Eddie McCready. Jim Baxter. Dennis Law. And McKenna making great space for himself. As Gemmell going up the right wing. This is Gemmell going in behind Wilson. And wins a corner. Gemmell wins a corner. Bobby Stiles saying that that was a goal kick. But it is a corner to Scotland. McCalliog going down with the ball. Dennis Law down there to take the short one. It is Law. Now Greaves. Moore. Hurst. McKinnon too fast for Hurst again. Biting in the tackle hard. Bremner. Good interception by Cohen. And it's Alan Ball. Now Bobby Charlton. Greaves lurking way out on the right. Peters coming with Charlton. This is Bobby Charlton. And a corner. Corner off the head of Baxter. Both teams beginning to look just a little tired out on this Wembley turf now, but England, I must say, are looking the more tired of the two teams. Bobby Charlton in the corner. Jack Charlton there. But it's Gemmell and now Wallace. Little Willie Wallace. A loose one. Moore takes it easily. This is Cohen, but quick interception by Gregg. Stiles finding Cohen again. Law going with Cohen. This is Cohen. Was Peters, Peters climbing up to try and head this equalising goal that England needs so desperately. Dennis Law for Scotland. Carry on. Greaves. Charlton. Again, this Scottish tackling, so quick, so fast, so incisive that they're forcing England into errors. This is Billy Bremner. Now Lennox. Baxter. Baxter again. And still it's with Scotland. McCalliog. Baxter. And that will be a foul, I would think, there somewhere. Referee talking to Bremner. And a free kick to England. Well, Scotland perhaps have only themselves to blame there for a little bit of gamesmanship. Now Peters. And Hurst brought down from behind. That's a free kick by McKinnon, who will be spoken to for kicking the ball away by referee Schulenberg. Bobby Moore. Peters. Charlton. John Gregg. John Gregg, number four. There he is, the Scottish skipper, and he certainly saved Scotland then. Jack Charlton got his head to it, and you can see John Gregg saying, come on, let's bear down, let's not lose this one goal lead. And Scotland very nearly did at that moment. Bobby Charlton for the corner. A chance for Cohen. Well, Billy, that was a very close shave for the Scottish goal.
Yes, I thought that was one in there, Hugh, but no, I would really like to praise the England side for this second half display, because they've really given even more than they had even in the first half when they were really struggling. The second half, they've not allowed Scotland to dominate because they've come into this game and they've had a couple of chances there that could have got them the equaliser. And I think this is only to be praised, because they've really got a Scottish side today who are on top form.
Free kick to Scotland. This has been a hard game, a strong game. There are a lot of strong men out there. Play their football hard, give their tackles and take their knocks. Baxter for Scotland. Wilson still having difficulty covering the ground. Charlton, Bobby Moore. Hurst trying for Greaves. Gemmell, Law outside him, this is Moore. Bremner leaving it for McCalliog. What a good ball, Law's offside. Dennis Law pointing to the linesman. Bobby Moore smiles at the look on Dennis Law's face. He really takes his football seriously. McKinnon again. Gemmell. Wilson now. Moore. Greaves. Ray Wilson. Bobby Moore. Too long for Greaves. Baxter. Charlton, and Peters in the clear. This is Big Jack Charlton. Peters still has it. McCready, he's passed, but Scottish defensive cover backing each other up quickly. Bremner finding Wallace. Law and Cohen. Charlton for England. Hurst, Greg covering well. This is Lennox. Bobby Lennox still there, now Stiles with him. And Stiles, a good strong tackle, takes that ball away from him. Good ball to Alan Ball. Moore to finding Greaves. Greaves got McKinnon to beat. Ronnie Simpson, 36 years old, but showing no signs of age as he took that one so smoothly. Now Dennis Law. Lennox. Bobby Charlton this time. Bobby Lennox, number 11, playing in his second international for Scotland, 22 years old, with something to remember today, obviously. Alan Ball, Jimmy Greaves. Greaves getting in trouble, but finds Peters. Bobby Stiles. Peters. Hurst, but McKinnon again. Now Wallace. Wee Wally Wallace. Baxter. And McCready. Law in the middle calling for it. McCready will probably play it back to Wallace. Yes, he does. Now then, McCulloch. No, Law tried an overhead scissors. I think if he'd left that one, McCulloch would have had a clear shot at goal. Hurst, Charlton. Brother Jack finds brother Bob. Alan Ball. Packed Scottish defence, giving England no chance when they get down near goal. Lennox, Wallace, Baxter, Law, Baxter. Scottish build up neat, and Baxter trying one. There he is, Jim Baxter. Lots of time to play the game this afternoon, and he's really been in this game. McKinnon again cutting out the danger for Scotland. This Wembley crowd, strangely quiet. Wembley fans, the Wembley Arena, where the England, England chant came up here 9 months ago when England won the World Cup. Now at this moment, resounding to that plaintive sighing, Scotland, Scotland. 40,000 Scotsmen making a lot of noise. Now Baxter. And Wallace, but it's Moore. Baxter again. Wallace. Greg McCready for Scotland. Plenty of spirit, he really puts everything into his football. But that time it cost him a free kick, and Scotland will take it with Baxter to McCready. And that's another free kick. Obstruction by Ball. And the dramatic signals of the West German referee pointing his finger one more time. One more time and off. You can see his lips moving then. But now another redhead, Billy Bremner, with the free kick for Scotland. And Ball comes away with it to Greaves, but Greaves gives it to Gemmell. Wallace to Lennox. Peters trying for Greaves, but only finding Gemmell again. Tommy Gemmell, the fullback, good ball to Wallace. Bobby Charlton back in his own defence now. Greaves easily taken out of the game by McKinnon, and pushing by McKinnon gives a free kick to England. Quickly taken. Bobby Charlton now finding a good ball to George Cohen. If he's got to be done, it's got to be done quickly. Cohen moving forward. McCready winning it. McCready had George Cohen angrily saying that was a corner kick, but it was in fact McCready playing the ball onto Cohen, and the ball went over the line for a goal kick. The fans trying to pick up the England chant again, but it's continually being drowned by the Scottish supporters' cries of Scotland, Scotland. But there isn't that punch, there isn't that snap about the England chant that there was in the World Cup those months ago. England, the world champions, are being made to struggle by this good, strong, fighting Scottish side. This is Gemmell now for Scotland. Baxter setting up a shot for himself. Moore. Now Greaves. Ball to Jack Charlton. Hurst, and again McKinnon is with Hurst. That was great that time. Baxter. Wallace Baxter. Greg McKinnon. Calliard has Wallace outside him on the left. This is Wallace. Jimmy Greaves, number 8. We've seen so little of him in the sharpshooting goal poaching role that England had hoped to see this afternoon. Free kick to be taken by George Cohen. That was a little push by McKinnon on Hurst. Stadium at Wembley now strangely quiet. About 15 minutes of the game left. England still trailing 1-0. The goal having been scored by Dennis Law but this could be an attacking position. This is Bobby Moore. That's Simpson. Baxter for Scotland. Now Wallace. McCallion. Lowers offside. Lowers 4 yards offside. Number 10, Dennis Law. Dennis the menace to England this afternoon. The scorer of Scotland's goal. Alan Ball. Bobby Charlton trying to find Cohen, he does. There's a whole flock of... And now Hurst breaking clear. Scotland were too casual then. They had plenty of men in defence, but a mistake. Jack Charlton there. John Gregg taking no chances, just hacks it into the crowd. Too quick a pass from Charlton, and now McCallion. Just 20 years old, playing his first international for Scotland. Finding Lennox. Calliope sprinting into the middle. But McCready is up there now for Scotland. To Baxter. Calliope Bremner. Calliope. Too much pat ball by Scotland there. Was Jimmy Greaves deep inside his own half. Bobby Charlton with McCallion challenging from behind. Now Hurst. Jeff Hurst, England's hero against West Germany, remember. Nobby Stiles. Jack Charlton going there, but Simpson very cool. Jim Baxter. Gregg to Bremner. John Gregg again. Scottish skipper, the Rangers man. Giving a very poor pass. Now Greaves. Charlton. Peters. Peters. Simpson. That Scotland have it again now with Willie Wallace, Dennis Law. McCallion going out to the left. Dennis Law trying it across this way. Willie Bremner, and a foul by one Manchester United man, number 4, on another Manchester United man, number 10. Nobby Stiles and Dennis Law.
How about that, Bill? A couple of Manchester United players telling each other what they thought about it. You and I wouldn't like to have been there with a microphone.
So, now it's Tommy Gemmell for Scotland. Moore gets his head in the way, and Gemmell has it again. And a chance here!
Try to pull this game out of the fire.
two redheads together, Alan Ball and Bobby Bremner, and the free kick to England. Again, McKinnon with his head. What a sound game this Scottish centre-half has played this afternoon. Peters for England. Cohen has McCready with him. And that will be a corner out to England. George Cohen picks himself up slowly. That was one London fullback on another London fullback. George Cohen of Fulham and Eddie McCready of Chelsea. And the crowd cheering England now, trying to get some action. Alan Ball with the corner. Simpson again gets this ball away. Scotland breaking their way through Law again. And here he is, number 11. Lennox finding number 7, Wallace. Turns round to see where his defence had got to. Number 7, Willie Wallace with the corner for Scotland. Time running out for England now. Alan Ball, Bobby Charlton, Jimmy Greaves. Jimmy Greaves. Bobby Moore, and again Ronnie Simpson down there. Alan Ball looking to see how on earth Simpson managed to get a hold of that one. Peters, Charlton, Bobby Charlton that is, and again the safe boot of McKinnon getting it away for Scotland. Moore and Bobby Charlton. And Baxter sticks out a boot to drag it away. Nothing at all goes right for England now. John Gregg. Baxter. Billy Bremner. Binding Lennox. Bremner. Again, Baxter has come in and out of this game, always been dangerous. Tommy Gemmell, Scotland slowing it down, taking the mickey out of this England side. And one wonders now, Billy, whether perhaps we're seeing this England World Cup side for the last time in this composition.
Well, on this performance, Hugh, they've been shown up by a much quicker, much more enterprising Scottish side, but one must take away from the fact they have been without Jackie Charlton for a great deal of this match. Now, that on this Wembley pitch is a great, great disadvantage, and so that I think that the England side, one or two of the forwards I'm disappointed with, but I still think the defence have done a magnificent job to hold the Scottish side like this, so that I think only up front would I criticise the England side.
The goals have come Scotland's way. England have not got them. They're 2-0 down as Bobby Charlton moves forward. Jack Charlton still bravely limping on. Hurst won't keep that in. And it's still in play with McCready. Leaving it for Law. So much fight in this Scottish side. Jim McAuliffe leaving it for Law again. Now Baxter. Law. Law. Jimmy Greaves. Alan Ball. Greaves again. Ball. Must be one here. Charlton. Yes, it is. Jack Charlton brave, limping England hero. Jack Charlton makes it 2-1. England 1, Scotland 2. About 5 minutes of this game left. Can England pull off a surprise draw now?
Football between these two sides I've seen for many a long time.
Offside has been given against Lennox. Well, certainly this game is really has everything, as Billy says. Scottish fans now, I can hear, giving encouraging whistles to referee Schoenberg to end this game. There's still about a minute of this game left. Handball against Wallace. Scotland wasting as much time as they can. Bobby Moore now with the free kick for England. Short one, Nobby Stiles. Bobby Moore trying the long ball into the box. Jack Charlton up there. How bravely this fellow has fought for England this afternoon. Themselves wonderfully in a fine Scottish side.